to our domain. Now, what's your first name?
Daniel.
Okay. Daniel, I just have you sitting here.
Okay.
And you got a piss or anything? You can have a sit there. That's probably
one. I could hold it. I'm not. I'm just.
All right. I'm gonna run right on out. Whatever's more comfortable, man.
Look up.
That'll work.
No chair for me. Let me bring a chair.
There's
no chair.
I was going to say there's a chair.
Huh?
I was going to say there's a chair.
No, right that there. I had back surgery.
Okay.
A year ago. Rocky's coming. But I didn't hear him. And I had a back fusion. Oh. This is about the only chair I can sit in. I don't
does
know
that
what
help your back support?
It does. Well, no, it gives. It's very giving. I'm turning this off because I don't want this back in this. And not to be yucky, but it's low back where my back fusion is, and I can put my butt right there,
mm-hmm.
so my tailbone's not getting extra pressure on it. I don't know. It. I can't sit in one of those. It'll kill me. Okay. Rocky's coming,
mm-hmm.
but I'm going to do this while, and he may walk in here in a minute and
okay.
get this done. Now, I know you're an officer, and I know you've seen these a thousand times
right.
and you've read them yourself.
Right.
You still ask me any questions if you have one.
Right.
Okay. Don't be embarrassed of that.
Right.
Okay.
I think I'm already embarrassed.
Why are you embarrassed? Why? Tell me why you're embarrassed.
The station deal, so.
Nobody. Well, I mean, there's rumors flying. I know. And we tried to do that as kind of quietly as we could. And that's why we took you out the front and stuff. But this is going to make the rumors go away.
Okay.
Okay? For you.
Right.
The rumor tomorrow is going to be on somebody else.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
So let's get them off of you
mm-hmm.
and get them onto somebody else and get this over with.
Okay.
Okay. All right. You have the right to remain silent. You understand
right.
that? Okay. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. Do you
right.
understand that? You have the right to talk to a lawyer and have him or her present with you while you're being questioned. You
right.
understand that? If you cannot afford to hire an attorney, one will be appointed to represent you before any questioning if you wish one. If you decide to make a statement, you may stop the interview at any time. You understand each of these rights I've explained to you?
I do.
Just write yes or I do or whatever right there. Oh, you're lefty too. Okay, hold on. You shoot right-handed, but you're right left-handed?
Yeah, I'm dexterous.
Me too.
So, a little bit.
I shoot right-handed and right left-handed. That's which do you
bat right-handed, throw left-handed.
Oh, I'm the opposite. I throw right-handed, but I bat left-handed.
Kick left foot.
No, I kick right foot. How do you eat?
Both hands.
Oh, left for me. Okay. Having these rights in mind, do you wish to talk to me and us at this time without an attorney
yes,
present? Okay, right, yes, right there. Read this out loud.
I've read the statement of my rights and understand what my rights are. I'm willing to make a statement and answer questions at this time. I do not want an attorney present at this time. Understand and know that what I'm doing, no promises or threats may have been made to me, and no pressure or force of any kind has been used against me.
Agree?
Agree.
Sign, print. That's too funny. I haven't met anybody else that writes left-handed. It kind of creates a problem when you're on a traffic stop, doesn't it? Because you're writing and holding your ticket book in this hand and your gun hand. Doesn't bother you? Well, that's because you're huge. What's your commission number?
1782.
I masturbate right and left. Okay. Does that work?
I think I do that left-handed.
Very good.
Well, I am dominant.
You are?
Yes. Okay. Look, just like we talked in the car. Mm-hmm. You haven't heard any rumors?
I haven't heard any rumors.
So
when I walked in the station, I see Captain leaned over. Not unusual. I got Captain Clifton, hey. But then... I've seen you in the cabin, I've never seen you, and so...
I'm a nobody.
But I haven't heard anything, okay. So I'm just looking at things.
You had said, and we told you that there was a traffic stop,
right.
That somebody made some allegations against an officer.
Right.
They don't know the officer's name, none of that. But, and you said that you made a traffic stop after work,
yeah. But
you didn't call it in.
I didn't call it in.
Where was that?
It was about Northeast 50th and... Lincoln, just to the west.
Okay. Tell me about that stop.
I was going westbound on Northeast 50th, probably a block just east of Lincoln. I see a red Grand Prix, or Grand Am, in my right lane, in the outside lane, I'm in the inside lane. The car swerves, and so at the time I'm thinking, okay, it's probably a drunk person, or maybe got excited because they saw a cop. So I kind of fall behind it, kind of drifting just a little bit, not crossing lane lines, nothing crazy. So I light it up because the traffic violation I saw at first when it swerved, that was just west of Northeast 50th and Lincoln. And then made contact, it was a black female, asked for license insurance, stated that she didn't have insurance, gave me an ID. At the time I'm like, do you have a valid insurance or a valid license? She said no. I told her, I just got off work. I mean, what's the deal? You know, why are you swerving? And she says, I'm just trying to go home to Ann Arbor-ish on the northwest side to see your daughter or something like that. So I asked, is there anything on board as far as the vehicle? Is it okay if I search your vehicle and whatnot? She said, the only thing that's inside there is a Kool-Aid cup. I'm like, is there anything inside in that Kool-Aid? Is there liquor or anything inside that Kool-Aid? She's no. I'm like, okay, is there anything else that's out there? She says, there's pills. I'm like, is that the only thing? And then, so I said, can I have permission to search your car? She says, yes. I go inside the car, I see a lot of pills. But,
What kind of pills?
I didn't really.
Like scattered pills or in a bottle?
She said it's hydrocodone pills, but I just quickly glanced, looked at it, and I think I saw her name on the prescription bottle, so I didn't.
Oh, so it was a bottle?
Right.
Okay.
There were several bottles in her purse. And then, so at that time, I just returned back to her. It's like, okay, I saw your pills. I didn't see any alcohol. I sniffed the drink, didn't smell any alcohol on the Kool-Aid. I'm like, okay, I'm just off work. I'm tired. Get your license taken care of. Just mine.
So she didn't have a driver's license?
She didn't have a driver's license. And I was just like, go to DPS, Department of Public Safety on King, get that taken care of. And I cut her loose after that.
Then where'd you go?
I went straight home.
Okay. Do you remember her name? It was on the
prescription. I don't.
Okay. Do you make traffic stops normally after work?
I don't, but in that case, I saw her swerve and whatnot, so I...
I mean, me, I don't...
Felt.
After I get off work.
I know, I mean, people
cops
say that
right.
Is have a, you know, whatnot, to have... The vision, whatever, but I felt like I needed to make that traffic stop.
Okay. How was she? Was she respectful? Was she
Felt like she was nervous and whatnot, and I'm like, why are you nervous? And she was even crying. I'm like, why are you crying? Why are you nervous? Whatnot? And she's just like, I don't know. I'm just nervous because you're a cop and I got pulled over. like, nothing you had to be nervous about. And I told her, I'm like, I don't really want to take you to jail for no SDL or anything. I just got off work. I'm tired. Mm-hmm. So with my officer, courtesy or whatnot, I said I'd go get that taken care of tomorrow. Let her on her way.
And you don't have to fix. I'm not going to sit here and go, why didn't you take her to die?
Well,
you're
that's
no, I don't care. Was she drunk? Did you think she was drunk?
I think she was. She drank, but I don't think she, with my experience, I don't think she was past the legal limit.
Right.
So
I mean.
And that's what I asked her too, is like, with your pain medicines, the hydrocodone, everyone knows that you drink with that, it maximizes the effects. So I asked her that, she said no. But I, when she was in the back of my car, when I was in the front car, in the driver's seat, I could smell it off of her, but I don't think she was still past the legal limit.
Okay. So you got her out of the car?
Yes.
Okay. And put her in the back of your car?
Yes.
Okay. Any problems there?
No, she was cooperative. Didn't give me any problems or whatnot.
Okay. And then you searched, did you run her through Unit 800?
I didn't.
You didn't? Mm-hmm. So, did you run her on your MDT?
No, I didn't. All my stuff as far as that, because I didn't even call it in and say it was a traffic stop, my computer was off and everything as well.
Did you shut it off?
I just shut it off, yeah. On the way, on 50th, I turned it off right before the traffic stop, basically.
Okay. And where did you pick her up, 50th and what about?
50th and Lincoln, just to the west.
But no, where'd you see her swerve, kind
of? I'd say a block just to the east of Lincoln and 50th.
Okay. She pull over right away?
She was in the right lane and the outside lane when I saw her swerve. And so she saw a police car right there, and so she kind of did what everyone does, slow down, kind of, okay, is he going to pull me over or not? And then I lit her up about 50th and Lincoln, past the intersection to the west.
Okay. When you put her in your car, did you pat search her?
When I came around, I was like, lift up your shirt. Is there anything on you? Anything as far as your waistband or anything like that? She said no. And then I put her in the vehicle and went from there.
Did your hands go on her at all?
I backhanded her on as far as the side.
Where on her body? Tell me. You backhanded
her waist. Her waist and the back portion. I didn't touch her butt or anything, but the back portion of the waist. And then she lifted it up like right here. And there's nothing.
Did she lift it up like this?
No.
Okay. So she never, like, went, ooh, nothing, no, exposed her breasts, no, or anything like that?
She asked me if I was like, no, it's okay.
She asked you?
If it, you want to search me, I'm like, no, it's okay.
So she never, like, put her hands on the car and you?
No.
Okay. Where was she positioned or standing when you did the back of your hand on her?
It was about probably the right, front right fender of my patrol vehicle.
But was she facing you or was she turned?
No, she was facing away from me.
And you just kind of did it like,
yeah,
this?
Yeah, back there, yes.
Okay. Did your hand go on her butt or
no,
anything?
No, that's what I was saying. It was the hip, the side, not the butt section.
What about right here?
No.
You didn't?
No, I didn't.
They can tuck a gun
and that's
right here.
Why I asked to lift it up.
Oh, so she just kind of showed,
yeah,
you her belly?
Right.
Okay. Then you talked to her for a little bit.
Right.
After you searched her, you,
right,
put her in the back of the car.
Right.
Then we used to always kind of keep the door open and talk when they're not, like, combative or anything. Did,
right,
you talk to her and get information then while she was in the back of your car?
Right. I talked to her for a little bit just as far as what's inside the vehicle. Can I have consent to search your vehicle? Is there anything in that Kool-Aid? She said no. Just talking to her. What's the deal? Why are you driving late at 2 o'clock at night, you know? Why did you swerve? So she's going to Ann Arbor on the northwest side to visit her daughter, I believe. So.
Then you went up and searched her car?
After she gave me consent to search her car.
How long, you think?
I did a quick search, to be honest with you. I looked under the seat, boom, sniffed the juice, whatever she's had, not in small alcohol on it. Went through her purse, like she said, there's pills in it. Looked at it real quick to see if their name was there. And that was basically it.
Okay. Then when you went back to her,
mm-hmm,
what happened?
When I went back to her, I was like, okay, I didn't smell any alcohol on your car and your juice thing. And I'm like, what's the deal? Are you really drunk or not? And she's like, no, I'm just trying to go back home. And at that time, I was like, okay, but I'll go ahead and follow you. I said, I'm not going to take you to jail. I'm tired. I'm not going to take you to jail. I'll go and follow you. And let's go back to 44 and you head westbound on 44. So that's what we did.
Did you follow her?
Actually, she... when I went behind her and we got in the car, she took forever, and I started getting annoyed, so I just U-turned it, and I went ahead, and I saw her in the back view of my rearview mirror, and she was following a 44, but then I took off, going northbound on Broadway Extension, while she took 44 to go west.
So you were able to see her do that?
Yes.
And go, and then when you, did you lose her when you got on Broadway?
When I went to northbound on Broadway, and she went 44 west.
Okay. Alright. Well, she's, it sounds like this is the lady, I mean, this is the deal where she's the complaining party.
Okay.
And she's making some sexual allegations, obviously, because sex crimes is working it.
Right. What did she say?
Well, was there anything, an accidental touch, anything?
If she thought it, when I passed surgery, but I didn't, it was nothing as far as I felt like I would do anything as far as sexual or anything like that. For my safety, I just checked to see if the weapons or anything.
And to make clear, I didn't touch
her butt, by the wayside and whatnot. If you would like me to do it, just for me to show you.
No, and I'm fine with it, and you have every right to do that. Right. She's saying that you made her lift up her shirt, and when she lifted up her shirt, she exposed her breasts.
No.
Did you ever see
I asked her, is there anything inside your bra? And she said, no. So I was like, okay. And she said, you want me to show you? And that's all the time I said, no. No, you don't need to do that.
She said she was doing this. When you said, is there anything inside your bra? And she was, well, no, I don't have anything like that. Did she do that?
Yeah, she did, but I didn't look or anything like that.
Right.
And then she was like, do you want me to show you? I was like, no.
She said, when she said, do you want me to show you? You said, yeah, and she went,
woo-hoo. No, I didn't.
But could she have been, woo-hoo, flashing you? And right. Now you don't want to tell me because you're afraid you're
going
to get in trouble?
No, when I told her no, I said no.
Then she didn't go, yeah, no. You know, because sometimes drunk girls are
having a good time.
Yeah, and partying down, and let's face
and
it.
I've already heard stories about officers
people
and whatnot.
They
and
want so officers want, for hubbies
want, so
or whatever.
I said no.
But you could have said no. But I'm asking you if she flashed you anyways.
I didn't see her. I didn't see her breasts.
Boobies?
I didn't see her breasts.
Okay. What about pants?
Nothing in her pants as far as that's concerned. She was wearing tight jeans. So.
She said she pulled them down.
Well, I didn't see it.
You didn't see her pulling down?
I didn't see her pulling down pants.
Could she have done it when you were up searching the car?
She could have.
Did she have them on?
I didn't have her handcuffed or anything.
When you came back to the car and got her out, were her pants fastened? Were they?
Yeah, everything.
They
was
were
still,
up and
everything was still intact.
So you never saw her pull her pants down?
No, I didn't.
Why do you think she's making this up?
I don't know.
Did you write her a ticket?
I didn't. I let her go, and I said I want to arrest you for your no STL.
Trying to figure out why she'd say that. I mean, I could see her saying it if you wrote her a ticket because she's pissed off.
Right.
Now, make it quite clear, if you saw her boobs, I don't care if she's flashing you.
I did not see her.
You did not see her boobies?
No, I did not see her breasts.
So she's saying you shined your light on her.
I did not see her breasts.
Where do you keep your flashlight?
The west side right here, right down my radio.
Did you have your flashlight out on the traffic stop?
I did.
When she was going like this, did you have your flashlight on her?
I didn't go like that. But as I'm out on the radio, like this, I have it right. Position over us, but I didn't.
Right, but did you have it on her when you're talking to her so you can see her? I mean, was it on her when she goes like this? Maybe she could have construed
it. To see her inside the vehicle.
Was the dome light on?
The dome light was not on.
It didn't come on? I don't know how. Does that come on when you open your back door? It's been too long since I've been in a scout car.
I can't recall, to be honest with you. I don't think it does. As far as the dome light.
I'm just trying to figure out. How long do you think you were on that traffic stop?
I don't think it was an excess of over a regular speed. 15 minutes at most, just like a regular traffic stop. Nothing as far as more.
15 minutes. How long were you with her? How long of that 15 minutes do you think was searching her car? Where she's, maybe she's sitting in the back seat.
Like I said, I did a quick search, probably at max maybe a little bit over 5 minutes, maybe like 5 minutes if.
So you're with her for 10 minutes?
Talking to her, yes.
Did it take a while to get her to consent to search, or what? 10 minutes is a long time.
She was nervous, and she was crying and stuff, and I told her not to
be nervous. Did she say why she was crying?
She says, police officer and whatnot, and I'm just nervous because I got stopped by a police officer. So I'm like, calm down, everything's fine. And then, so I think maybe with the fact that she had no SDL, maybe she was nervous as well, too. And then, so I went to the search, and it wasn't that, it was a quick search, like I said before. It wasn't in detail, pulling up carpet. It was a quick search.
Because you were just ready to go home.
I was ready to go home.
Did you go home, go straight to bed?
I went home straight to bed.
Think of anything yet?
Oh, I think that was pretty good. Wasn't that pretty easy? Hey, we got to do this.
Okay.
Okay, if you don't mind. I got to take your buckles.
Buckle?
We're doing that in the...
That's fine.
All right.
Did we buckle swap anybody in the academy? As a demonstration?
Yeah. I'll let your name there, because I don't even know how to spell it.
How do you say your name?
Daniel Holtzclaw.
Holtzclaw. What is that?
It's German.
Can you speak German?
No, I can't.
Oh.
Hey, read that out loud to me.
I, Daniel Holtzclaw, after having been advised of my right not to have a search made of my body, hereinafter mentioned without a search warrant, and my right to refuse to consent to such a search, hereby authorize Rocky Gregory, detective of the Oklahoma City Police Department, to conduct a complete search of my body located at 71 Colcord, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Officers are authorized by me to take from my body samples of swabs from my body which they may desire. This written permission is being given by me to the above named police official voluntarily and without threats of promises of any kind.
Basically, you're giving buccal swabs on of your own free will.
Okay.
We do this as part of. This ain't so bad, huh?
Well, I never asked that, so.
Right. There we go. And you get a free teeth cleaning with your first time.
You won't go numb, though.
All right, and then we're going to have one more round.
I turned off my phone.
Well, I have a couple more questions.
What time is it on your watch? I turned my phone off. So.
I've got 4:47. What I've got. So do you usually do traffic stops on going home, or what was?
I don't. Like I said before, I rarely don't. I usually try to get home because I'm tired of them.
Well, and are you a big DUI worker?
When I first started coming out, I did. But not really at the end now, to be honest with you.
I usually, if I see somebody swarming, I'm the other way.
And that's what a lot of officers do too, so.
Well, Daniel, this is kind of one of the things that we kind of bring in here to see how truthful you are.
Right.
Now, you need to kind of think of a few different things here.
Okay.
We pulled up a lot of video around that area
after
these allegations.
Okay.
She also had a SANE exam, which you know what that consists of.
Right.
There's a reason why we wanted your buckles.
Okay.
Now, I mean, we can go through a couple different things of why we've got you in here, but you sure there's nothing you want to?
Nothing.
So if we go off the video and watch that.
Right.
You're still going to stick with your story.
Yes, sir.
If we go off DNA?
DNA as well.
Should we show you the video?
If yes.
You do want to see it?
Do I? Yes.
So there's nothing that...
Everything that I recall of that night is what was I asked and everything. That's what happened.
Have I maybe not asked enough questions?
I think everything covered as far as that.
Do you recall putting your penis in her mouth?
I don't.
Would you recall that if you did it?
If I did it, yeah.
Okay. Well, I think you really, in all honesty, you need to really double think about this. I mean, I got to be honest with you. It doesn't look really good.
Okay.
I mean, in what you originally thought, detectives just don't roll up in there for no reason.
Right.
Okay. And we just didn't pick you out. Okay.
Right.
I mean, there's a whole lineup there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But there's definitely enough here to bring you in here to start questioning you.
Right.
Okay. We knew you were on that stop.
Right.
We knew you were there.
Mm-hmm.
And we can watch a whole lot of actions being performed while you were there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And that's why she was trying to give you every out on the whole booby thing.
Right.
Okay. Now, is there any reason at all, even from whatever angle, because, you know, it takes a little bit to clear up those videos.
Right.
But any reason why your penis would be out?
No.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Okay. Now, in doing this, you know how SANE exams work, and I ain't got to explain about DNA or anything like that.
Right.
Now, I didn't say you had sex with her.
Right.
Okay. But getting a blowjob, okay, that is a different story.
Right.
Okay. You see my concern here.
I'm just listening to you, sir.
I know. But I'd rather listen to you and you start talking.
That's all I have, sir.
Are we going to get something from the SANE exam?
Go with the SANE exam.
Do you understand that you don't have to full-blown ejaculate to get something out of the SANE exam?
Right.
We can get skin cells. We can get pre-ejaculate. We can do all that and still get DNA.
Right.
And... did your penis go in her mouth?
No, it did not.
Okay. Because DNA will clear it up. And here's the deal, too. We can fall on the sword.
Okay.
And say I screwed up or something. But if we say we didn't do it, and then the DNA comes back and says he did it, then we have a huge problem.
Right.
We're here to give you the chance to fall on the sword, so we don't want a huge problem. We don't want a huge problem for you.
Right.
It's time. If it touched her mouth, if it touched the inside of her mouth for 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, you gotta tell us now.
Look, there's a huge difference. There's a huge difference in between a rape being forced,
mm-hmm,
and some old girl who wants it.
Right.
Okay. We've had plenty of that.
We get that. Right. We know that.
Okay, but there is a big difference, okay?
Right.
But I'm just saying, you know, these videos ain't helping, and I mean, we're going to do the comparing and all that.
Okay.
Okay? But it's not looking good so far.
Okay.
Okay? And I don't want to see anybody go down for something that
right.
there was no force.
Right.
Now, I'm not seeing any beating or anything like that.
Right.
Okay? I'm not seeing that big time. Big guy forcer type thing like what we do see.
Right.
But,
you know. If it was a get out of jail free card, that happens.
Right.
And we know that happens.
Right.
But we gotta know that. We gotta know that versus, you know, he made me, I didn't want to, blah, blah, blah. If it's a get out of jail free card, then that's a different story.
And we've worked enough of them, okay, cases that it didn't happen. The problem is where we're at right now,
mm-hmm,
okay? And that's why we wanted to hear your version of the story.
Right.
Whether we just go off of what we see and I mean, whatever this tests out as.
Right.
Okay? But.
Sir, I'm sticking with my story. Okay.
On the video, are we going to see her boobies?
Shouldn't see her boobs. I didn't see her boobs.
Okay. Are we going to see her pull her pants down?
I didn't see her pull her pants out.
Are we going to see your penis out?
Nope.
Are we going to see your penis go in her mouth?
No.
Are we going to get any DNA to that?
No.
Let's switch up for a second. You had another girl, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You probably don't not necessarily going to remember the name, but her name is Terry Morris. Okay, black female. Supposedly you promised her a ride to the city rescue mission. This ring a bell?
No.
You did a traffic stop with her. She thought you ran for warrants. Was it clicking? You drove her around.
Mm-hmm. No. My name doesn't, I don't recall a name like that.
She's claiming the same thing. The exact same thing. And here again, for whatever reason, things are pointing at you again.
Right.
Now, this was before even this incident this morning. Traffic stop, not logged in, all that stuff.
This morning?
No, no. This has been a little bit ago.
Okay.
This was here just a couple of weeks ago.
Okay.
Okay. Anything?
Do you remember
stopping?
I don't recall a name. Okay. Terry Moore.
Well, I wouldn't remember a name.
How about black female downtown city rescue mission? That's what I was trying to jog your memory.
I haven't been to a city rescue mission.
I didn't say you made it there.
Have you promised anybody a ride to the city rescue mission?
I haven't asked anyone ask me to city rescue mission.
No, she didn't have to ask you. Did you offer to take anybody to the city rescue mission?
No, I don't offer anyone because I don't like going there. Be honest with you, I don't
like dealing with what?
I don't like going over to the city rescue mission or anything like that.
Okay. How about any stops of a person just walking, even just downtown? Anywhere downtown?
No. I don't go downtown. Besides if I go to Classen, not Classen, but Western and Main, to Valero's.
Jail.
Our jail.
Or headquarters, right. Property.
Right.
And you just don't remember doing any of those type of stops?
No.
Not in the last month or so?
No.
Do you run everybody that you come in contact with?
Majority of the time.
But you didn't run old girl this morning?
The 50th.
The 50th in Lincoln?
No, I didn't. I didn't run her.
The other girl that he's talking about is kind of making the same allegations, and that's weird.
Yeah, that
doesn't look good.
It doesn't look good.
So, no one with the city rescue mission, never been asked, never been offered anyone to go there.
Do you give people rides sometimes?
I do give people rides.
Do you?
I do.
Because sometimes I'd be like, I am not a taxi cab.
Okay.
But
have you always been in your new car? I mean, have you ever had it down? Driving another?
I've had a wreck on 27th and King where it was down for a little bit. Starting out, was in the pool cars, but this is my take-home car.
But I'm saying in the last month, have you been driving any of the older cars?
No.
Black and white versus the solid black?
Yeah, I think this is the only car I've been in.
Have you ever driven a black and white car?
I have, yeah.
When was that?
Right out of academy, regular Crown Vic.
But when you wrecked your car and it was down, what did you drive?
The Crown Vic, black and white.
A black and white one.
Right.
When was that?
A year ago, maybe.
Oh, okay. So. How long have you had to take them for?
Probably a year and a half.
And it's been this one?
This one, yeah.
So you wrecked it 6 months after having it?
Somewhere around there, yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Is it your fault?
No.
Well, that's good.
What do you think about all this?
Heads out here. I want you to take the exam and get this over with. I feel embarrassed because going to the station.
That's why we try to handle it.
Right. And I've heard of officers going through this and whatnot, and that's something I don't want my rep to be, you know, about. You know, I'm a good officer. I don't, that's not me. It's not me.
Are you circumcised?
I am circumcised.
Sorry, just asking. Do you have pubic hair?
Yes.
Well, I mean, some people manscape, as you call it.
Right.
You groom?
I groom, okay. Yes.
So do I.
You got any identifying marks around your penis?
Or? I don't.
Just the plain old penis, huh?
Plain old penis.
Plain old 14-incher.
I don't say about that, but...
See, you should have. You just had your opportunity. I just don't know what to think. Would you take a polygraph?
Yeah, if you want to take a polygraph.
I mean, I'm trying to think of a solution. Do you know how slow DNA is?
I don't. I do not.
Slow. You'd be willing to take a polygraph on it?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm calling. Get that set up.
That's kind of delving off different, but you married?
I'm not married.
Girlfriends?
Here and there.
Kids?
No kids.
You're big. You on roids?
I'm not on steroids.
A little bit.
I've been always.
Which I don't care.
I've always been a big.
I'm not the dope police.
I've always been a big bone guy, football, athletic.
You got more than big bones. You got big muscles too.
I work out all the time.
Do you?
I do.
Where do you work out?
At a 4-star gym off of May, about 63rd.
Yeah. No roids at all.
No roids.
You do all the protein drinks and all that stuff.
I drink a lot of protein.
That can damage your kidneys, just so you know.
So.
If you did roids, would you tell us?
I would. I'll tell you.
I mean, because we don't care.
I have nothing to hide about that. I've always been a big guy. I always work out all the time and whatnot.
When was the last shower you had?
Took a shower before work.
When you went home, was anybody home?
My girlfriend was home.
Did you live with her?
Huh? No, she didn't. She just stayed.
Did you get laid?
Messed around, yeah.
What's messed around? Sex?
I guess.
We were all adults.
We almost had sex, and she was tired.
What'd you do?
So, my penis went around her vagina, and then maybe went a little bit in, and then she pushed me off and said, no, we don't want to. I'm tired. I was like, okay.
That's kind of mean to let it get that far and then stop.
So
that's when you got home?
That's when I got home.
How often do you have sex?
About once a day, if that.
You guys have sex once a day?
Yeah.
How old are you?
27.
Well, yeah.
How much you jerk off?
Maybe once a day.
So you have sex once a day and masturbate once a day?
Yeah.
What'd you do when you got shot down at home today? Usually you gotta relieve that.
Right. That's,
I know.
That was before work. That happened before work.
You masturbated before work?
Yeah.
Did you just go roll over and go to sleep when she didn't give you any?
Yeah.
You ever been accused of anything like this before?
I haven't.
Not in Michigan?
No. I have not.
You weren't one of those football players.
I wasn't.
See
I
the
wasn't.
News.
I was not.
Anything? Anything you can think of that will help us help you?
That's it. I want to
step up.
I want to go. Test. I want to get clear on my name.
Because we, you know what? If this is a bunch of false allegations, then I want it cleared up too.
Right.
And I'll help you clear it up. We don't talk. It's not it's swarming around Spring Lake. It's out there.
It's just in the department too.
Not swarming all over the department. We in sex crimes, we do not run around and go, guess what? This is what we're working on. We don't do that. It's not professional. I'm not going to lie to you. It's around Spring Lake.
Right.
And everybody's going to know that we pulled you down here. We tried to do it as discreetly as we could.
Right.
But, and like I said, there's officers that, I'm not saying being with the hookers is right, but it happens.
Right.
And it's life.
Right.
And if that's what this was, lay it out there for me now.
Right. No, it wasn't. No.
Did she offer anything? Don't take me to jail. I'll do this. Offer you anything?
I think she was nervous, like I said earlier, and maybe a little flirtatious, but nothing crazy.
She never offered anything in exchange for you not taking her.
No, she's really worried about going to jail, but. And
sometimes they'll say, hey, I'll give you a hammer if I don't go to jail.
No.
She didn't offer that?
Mm-hmm. She was nervous. Like I said, she cried earlier.
Did she cry as soon as you stopped her or after she was in your car? When did she start crying?
I think in the car, yeah.
What made you let her go? Number one.
To be honest, I wanted to get home.
Then why'd you pull her over?
Like I said earlier, I just cop, swerve, DUI. And if I had to do it, I would have done it. But I didn't think that she was past the legal limit.
I just would avoid that if I. Did you at any time? You said you picked her up around 50th and Lincoln. I mean, when you saw her swerve.
Right.
Did you at any time? Were you always behind her, or did you pull up beside her to maybe see who was in the car and then pull back behind her?
She was at 50th and Lincoln, swerve, and I was behind her, so I felt behind her. And then wait till
we passed. Ever beside her?
No.
What lane was she in?
The Miles High lane.
Closest to the curb?
Yeah.
Did you ever pull up beside her on this way and then fall behind her?
No.
Because
I was directly behind her about here, and she swerved.
And you stayed behind her? Because sometimes I would pull up beside to see, okay, how many people am I dealing with?
In
the car.
I didn't do that time. I've done that before, but
right, you didn't do that.
I didn't do it this time.
No. Could you tell if she was the only passenger?
I couldn't. It was dark tinted windows. I couldn't tell.
So you didn't know how many people you were walking up on?
No, I didn't.
Did she roll down her window as soon as you?
She had the back left window rolled down, and then she didn't ever rolled it up, and I think she opened the door, if I recall.
Okay. And was it pretty quick that you took her to the back, to your car?
After a couple questions, license, insurance, typical thing, she just gave me her little Oklahoma identification card. And that's like, okay, investigate attention, come back to the car with me.
Okay. Yeah, because that gives you a reason to search if you need it. I mean, what would you have done if you had found some dope or a gun or something?
As officers, if you find a little dime bag, it's, you can squash it out, rub it out. With gun, obviously, different story.
And you logged out when?
I don't know the exact time, but off Prospect, when I about hit Prospect, and probably about 50th, I logged out.
Do you guys, because it's done different now, do you have to go to the station and check all your stuff in?
Hand interactivity and all that.
You do that every night?
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't go to a buddy here, turn this in, I'm going home.
And then lieutenants clear us and say you guys could go home.
Okay. So you didn't. And what? Do they make you wait till straight up two, or do they catch you?
Majority of the time. Sometimes it's just up to the supervisor.
Okay.
The majority of the time.
And then you left.
And then I headed up 50th. Going northbound.
How'd you get to 50th? Just down Prospect?
Spring Lake Station, take a right to go north off Prospect, take a left to go westbound off 50th.
And then picked her up at Lincoln.
About there-ish to the east where I saw her.
Any other traffic out there?
No, that was the only car.
What about during the time that you had her stopped for like 15 minutes? Was there a lot of traffic going by? Was there any traffic going by?
I think there was cars I could see as far as coming going west towards our direction and whatnot. But nothing like real crazy driving by us all the time.
Step out.
Yeah. Hang for a minute. Let us powwow.
My shirt kept in there.
I
Your phone. I wanted to, they, looking in your car.
Oh, okay.
But they wanted you to have your phone.
Okay.
All right. So we have no misunderstanding because, and maybe I didn't key in on some things. I want you to, you turn in your activity card, walk me through it all again.
Turn in my activity card, I leave out of station, I go take a right, go northbound on Prospect, all the way to 50th. About that time, turn off my computer, I'm done for the night, head left, go westbound on 50th from Prospect. About a block down, I see a red Grand Prix in the outside lane. I was in the inside lane, directly in front of me. Car swerved at that time. I kind of fall behind of it. Then initially it lighted up until we hit about 50th and Lincoln. I didn't want to light it up at the stop sign, so I waited till it go forward and just lit it up just to the west. And then that's when I made the traffic stop.
Okay, walk me through the stop.
Made the traffic stop, made contact, gave her license, insurance, normal protocol.
Mm-hmm.
She gave me her identification card. And then at the time I said, you have a valid driver's license? She said, no. So I was like, okay, I had to step out of the vehicle.
Did she have insurance?
She didn't bring me, didn't get insurance. So I just saw the ID and I was like, yeah, valid insurance. Need a valid license. So I brought her back to the house, the car. And then that's when I...
Okay, what side of your car?
The back right.
The passenger side?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Go ahead.
So as I'm walking her down, I was like, you have any weapons or whatever? I always ask people when I step out of the car, whatnot. At that time, I powder her down, whatnot. Ask her to lift up her shirt. No weapons as I could see or anything like that. Put her in the back of my car. Ask her what the deal is. She's going to Ann Arbor on the northwest side to visit her daughter, I believe. And then I'm like, okay, why were you swerving? Why are you late at 2 o'clock at night driving and whatnot? What's the deal? She's like, I'm just going to my daughter's house. Okay, so why are you swerving? She's just like, I got nervous or something or whatever the deal is. So I ask her, okay, and I go, is there anything inside the car I need to know about? And then she says, there's some juice in there. I was like, is there an alcohol in the juice? She says, no. So I was like, anything else inside the car? She's like, oh, you might just find some pills and whatnot. So I proceeded and asked, can I have consent to search the car? She says, yes. Go to the car, I did a quick search, nothing out of, you know, didn't look up any carpets or anything like that. Did a quick search, looked under the seat, looked through her purse, saw the pills, smelled the juice. I didn't smell any alcohol in the juice. When I looked at the pills, I kind of quick glanced to make sure it was her name, whatnot. Okay, we're good. Went back over there, okay. And what's the deal with this, blah, 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 whatnot. And she's like, I'm just trying to go see my daughter. And then I was like, okay, I don't want to go. I don't want to take you to jail. I'm tired. I want to go home. And then she's like, okay. So basically went from there and I said, I'll follow you. Follow you around. We got in her car. She took it forever. So I pulled out, did a U-turn in front of her. She followed me where I could see her in the rearview mirror. We went over and I went northbound on Broadway Extension. She went 44 and west. And that was it.
Why'd you log off?
I always log off.
Aren't you supposed to stay logged on until you get home?
I always log off.
Do you keep your police radio on when you go home?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're listening.
I think I have my radio on, yes.
Do sometimes you turn them off?
Yeah, I do.
Sometimes. That's not good officer safety. What if you drive by an armed robbery?
That's true, too, yeah.
I mean, or what if you drive by an officer that needs backup and you're
right
there and you didn't hear it?
That's right.
I'll give you my mommy lecture. So you always log off when you're done?
Majority of the time, yes.
Okay. When you bring her to the passenger side of the car, here's her car. I'm not a good artist either. And here's your car.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you bring her over here.
The back right.
Okay.
Passenger side.
Is this where you're having your conversation the whole time?
The whole time when I step out of the car, I'll always talk to him when he had anything on you. So as we're walking here, I'm like, okay, anything on you? Okay, be careful. I just quick pat you down, whatever. Just go ahead. Quick pat her down. No, I don't have weapons, I felt, or anything like that. I looked at your shirt, about right there. Nothing. Okay, keep walking. Still checking her out, making sure everything's good. And I'm like, anything your shoes? No. Try to take off your shoes. I'm like, are you good? So get inside the car, and that's when I proceeded to ask anything on board.
Okay, so she got inside the car.
She got inside the
car. Did you go get in the car and talk, or did you stand there with the door open and talk to her?
I think I did get inside the car for like a quick minute and just see what's the deal. It's just talking to her and whatnot. And that's the time where I think I smelt the alcohol just a little bit on her. But nothing, for, I didn't stay in the car forever and whatnot. Just talked to her for a quick, brief minute.
And then you went up and searched?
Yeah, I got consent to search the car, asking if anything's on board. She said, juice. I was like, any alcohol in the juice? No. Anything else I should know about before I go inside the car? I'm going to find it. She said, pills. Okay, I was like, all right. I didn't ask her specifically where the pills were.
Right.
So I go inside the car, look down the front left seat, quick search, and look at their car, because anything I said, smelled the juice, not as smelling the alcohol. I went through her purse. First, I saw bottles of pills and whatnot, but just quick glance, okay, that's her name. You know, went back.
Now, when you went back, did you get in your car or did you go back over here?
I don't know if I went into my car or went back over there, to be honest with you. I don't know.
Did you, sometimes, like I said, we open the car door and we stand, car door's open, and I'll stand right here and talk to them because they're sitting right here.
What? I've done that, yeah.
Did you do that
with
her?
Yeah, I did that, yes. Yes.
So you're having conversation while she's sitting in the car
right
there?
Right, yes.
Okay, but you don't remember if you got back in here?
I know, I believe I did get back in the car. That's when I smelled just a slight of alcohol on.
That was pre-search?
I believe so. I believe okay. so, I don't know.
And I'm trying to get this so we can match it up with
right.
the video.
Right.
After you search, you come back over here and talk to her?
Right.
Okay. Any cars passing by then?
Maybe a couple.
Could she have missed? Because if you're standing right here and you're a big guy,
right,
and she's sitting right here, if she goes like this, well, she's gonna be looking right at your penis.
Okay, but it was just talking.
Did you? Let me ask you this: did you ever get a hard on while you were talking to her? Because she could have.
I don't think these pants
fit the greatest. Right. And if you get a hard on, I'm going to be able to tell you get a hard-on.
Right, and I'm pretty positive I didn't get a hard-on.
Didn't get a hard-on when you talked to her? Well,
positive.
Do you still just get boners because you get boners?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. So, have you ever got a boner on a call?
I'm pretty sure I have.
Okay.
Pretty sure I have.
But it's not something you would
no.
remember? I mean, I would remember if I got a hard-on
right.
talking to somebody.
And as a guy, it happens.
That's not something. I know.
So.
Well, you're not 50 yet either, so happens because of your age. Could she have could you have got a hard on and she saw it and
I don't think I got a hard on, but like I said, she was already nervous and crying and whatnot. I already told her, I'm like, hey, I want to go home. I'm done with my shift. I don't think you'd be worried about it. If nothing's on board where I need to take you to jail, you're good. I'm not worried about no state driver's license.
Did your pants come unzipped, unbuttoned, anything while you were standing right there?
No.
CSI is processing your car right now.
Right.
And when we stepped out, they found some pubic hairs right in here. Could they be yours?
No, that's not. I didn't pull my penis out and do anything right there.
Did she?
No.
So you think it could be?
No, it's not. No. Nothing online.
Your pubes couldn't be?
No.
Right there?
No.
Has your penis ever been out by your car?
While I'm working? No.
Not working?
No.
Have you ever had sex in the backseat of your car?
I have not.
Because, I mean, some people do. I mean, I'm not saying forced sex, consensual sex.
Right.
So your penis has never been in your backseat?
Mm-hmm.
Is it possible any of this DNA is yours?
No. It's not. I would like to go at it. Not my DNA.
Are those pubes going to be yours?
No. No.
Are you worried about it?
This whole situation I'm worried about. I mean, I've never been here, never been questioned, especially in the, you know, like a room like this, you know. Obviously, I'm worried about the whole circumstances of
earlier. You got to understand, we kind of see different things, okay? You seem a little extra worried whenever you talked about seeing her. We talked about seeing her boobies. You sure she just didn't flash you?
She did not flash. I don't want to say I can't recall, but I'm pretty positive she didn't flash
me. I see a pair of titties.
She went like this, but nothing as far as I'm going like crazy looking.
Lifting the shirt.
No.
How far
she
lifted?
She lifted it at first, and when I patted her down, she was like right here to the stomach line.
Did you see her belly?
Maybe some fat rolls or something, I don't know, but nothing.
Right, but I mean, could you see skin?
Yeah, I saw skin, yeah.
Well, she's older. Were tits hanging down, and you saw the bottom of her tits?
I don't know. I don't know. It's dark. I don't know.
You like older women?
I don't.
How old's her?
She's 25.
Okay.
What's the oldest lady you've slept with?
Maybe 29.
You ever slept with a black woman?
I have. In high school, I have.
Do you have a race that you prefer?
I don't.
You just like...
I'm half Japanese, so I'm not really...
I was going to ask you if you were Asian. Anything,
so I'm not really discriminating.
Who's Japanese, your mom or your dad?
My mom.
Is your dad huge? How'd you get so big?
That's what everyone asks me.
No, because, Asian genes are kind of small.
And that's why I thought I was adopted at first when I talked to him, but my dad's small, 5'9". Oh. Japanese people are small in general, so...
Wow. How tall are you?
About 6'2".
Wow. Does daddy have some big guys on his side?
He's a family of three. Well, he'll be with him with four brothers, but I think his generation, his uncle was pretty tall, and I think that's where I got it.
I think we've covered a lot of the sex questions.
Yeah, is there anything? You got any sex questions?
I don't.
You got anything of us?
I don't. I just, this whole situation and just...
It's kind of scary.
It is scary. I don't want my rep to be... Everything's about, in law enforcement, I'm 3 years on. I know that, but everything's about your rep.
Absolutely.
And I don't want this to fall on my rep.
Actually.
So...
Why would she make? Because when a woman says something like this, and they go through a same exam, and they get, you didn't give her a ticket, so she's not getting out of a ticket. You didn't arrest her, because we get those when they go to jail. I've been raped, and have to work those stupid things because they think they're going to get out of jail.
Right.
Why in the world would she make this up?
I don't know. She was cooperative. She was. Nervous, like I said earlier, crying. I told her I'm not worried about no state driver's license. I wasn't making...
She said she was crying.
Yeah, and I don't... You know, at times as an officer, you might make a threat to be like, oh, I'm going to take you to jail. But let's try to get some way to get in the car or something, you know, like a gang
right.
or something. But that wasn't the case. I wasn't threatening her. I wasn't...
Did she ever ask you if you were going to shoot her?
She did. She was talking about a pistol. All the time, and it's talking about guns and whatnot, and I'm like, calm down. I'm like, I'm not gonna shoot you or anything like that.
Did she think you were gonna shoot her?
Maybe. I'm like, what? And I even asked her. I think I asked her, what's the deal with you and cops? You have a bad run-in with a cop. That was it.
So you had to tell her.
That's like calm down.
Did you ever say, I promise I'll let you go?
I did. I said, I promise I'll let you go. I'm not worried about no state driver's license. Is there anything inside that car?
Did you tell her you're going to follow her home?
I did. But then when she took forever to turn around, I got annoyed and I was like, screw it, let's go. But I saw in the rearview mirror, and I saw her take 44 when I went northbound on Broadway.
Where did she live?
She said she was going to sister's house in Ann Arbor.
Were you really going to follow her? That's far.
I was going to drift off, and I might really follow her, but I'm just going to drift off and, okay, she's good to go. So I didn't think at first she was drunk. She wasn't over the legal limit. But my thought of alcohol was on board, but nothing where she's DUI.
Anyway, those pubes are going to be yours.
No, they're not. Please.
I know. We're going to test it. It just takes. Anyway, your skin cells are going to be anywhere on her mouth.
No.
Skin cells from your fingers.
No.
Did you touch her body anywhere other than with the back of your hand, pat searching her?
Just pat searching her. That was about it. Didn't touch her face or anything.
You got to understand, we've had so many people sat in that same chair that tell us all day long, I didn't do this, I didn't do this. They promise on their baby, on their mama.
Right.
They promise to God. And then they come right back. We get back these tests, and you can't get out of it, you know? I mean, once you kind of get basically kind of locked into something, there's no talking about it.
Right.
And that's why we would try to give a person every opportunity.
Right.
Because if the tests come back, you ain't coming back in here.
Because we have a woman that says about, basically being sexually assaulted.
Right.
Okay? And we're calling it by force and all that. Big difference between that and a hookup.
Right.
And to come back, if there's something there and you say no, and she said it was that, you see where we're going.
Right, I do.
And that's why we always try to give every angle.
Right.
But he wasn't there.
Right.
So we just got to go off of everything that we see and have.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you understand?
No hookup?
No hookup.
Not even a little hookup?
No, not a little hookup.
No boobie?
No boobie. I saw no breasts.
Did she see your penis?
No.
I'm just trying to think of anything that she could have misconstrued. Or why. Why'd she go to all this trouble?
I don't know.
Did you do anything that pissed her off?
That's what I'm saying. I don't think I did anything when I was talking to her. I don't know. Was it rude? She was cooperative. I wasn't at a point where I'd be like, okay, you're going to jail or something or whatnot. I don't think I made any, threats to make, to get in the car, like I said, or anything like that.
When we first walked into the office, first time you saw us, okay?
Right.
And we just kind of started talking. You brought up this traffic stop.
Because the major came in, or the captain, talking about 50th and Lincoln.
And, okay.
When he came and got you?
Yeah.
What did he say to you?
I think it was the captain, and then we were in the major's office, and he said something, accusations of 50th and Lincoln. And I didn't hear any rumors going into the station or anything. I was just going to show up and line up like I normally do.
When you came in, you said something about, wow, why are all them guys here?
I don't think I said that. I was shocked.
In the car, not to, you were like, when I saw everybody, I was like, whoa, wonder.
Because I was.
Did you think we were there for you?
I was just, what I saw that, and I knew from Academy, what's going on.
Did you think it was for you?
I didn't know. I didn't see it. I've never been in trouble like this before. Never got accused of anything like this or nothing.
But it scared you.
Yeah, I was scared.
Okay. If I walked into the station and saw some sex crimes detected there, that wouldn't scare me.
It wouldn't scare me if I was just in the briefing station. But since I went in the room and was told to go in the room, and I saw
then
your sex crimes.
Okay.
That's what went on.
But I saw you when you walked in the door. Did you see me in the captain's office?
I saw you, but I saw the captain glance over like that.
Did you get scared then?
No. I'm good with Captain Clifton.
Are you?
And just say, hey, what's up all the time. So it wasn't a big deal to me like that. And when he told me.
But when you got called in then and you were like, whoa.
Yeah, what's going on?
What's your phone number?
580-231-2028.
Did you exchange phone numbers with this lady?
I did not.
Did she have a phone?
I did not, no.
Did you talk about hooking up later?
No, I did not.
Is she somebody you'd hook up with?
No.
Did she want to hook up later?
I don't know. She didn't give me any clues like that.
Did she ask for your number?
No.
I'm just trying to think of every conceivable possible thing for this.
run down through on your search of her breasts again. Exactly how that went, because even that and her pants.
Was she standing or sitting?
When,
during that time.
Patted when I got to the vehicle about right here. Said, can I search you?
At more by the front door.
The front right fender. And then I patted her down, boom, boom, boom. Lift up your shirt right here. Boom, no weapons.
So you said lift up her shirt. Your shirt.
Yep.
What if that would have, she would have gone, whoa!
Then I would have been, I would have told a supervisor or something. I'd be like, get that off my back. You know, it's not what I meant.
You searched her with her, where was her, was she facing you or facing away?
Facing away.
She's facing away.
Right.
And how are you seeing if anything's falling, if she's facing away?
If it'd fall, I'd see right there.
You'd see right there, but don't you usually have them turn face towards you and do a shakeout?
Officer safety, always have everyone face away from me. You can't see what you can't hit.
But you don't know if the weapon's there or anything?
As far as I did, quick pad search, lift up your shirt, no weapons on board.
You made a mention earlier about her pants. She did what with her pants?
As far as that, it was in the back seat. Nothing. She had tight pants, and that's about it.
But how did you have her do it? Like a cursory movement around her belt line, anything like that, or any shake?
No.
Did you tell her how far to raise her shirt or to do the shake with the bra? Anything like that?
I think she did the shake with her bra by herself. I didn't say to do any of that. As far as the...
She pulled it out and go like that?
Yes, but as far as... That's on her. As far as right here is when I told her to lift up the waistband.
But she was faced away from you the entire time that her chest was...
Right.
She was checking.
Right. Right.
So when she lifted up her shirt, her back was to you?
I think she was facing me, obviously, because I'm going to look at the front end.
You said you might have saw her belly, like a fat roll.
Right.
So you would have been to the side or to the front?
If the time when she faced me is probably when I would have saw a fat roll or skin.
But it wasn't for the check?
No.
Did she try to pull her pants down?
No, I recall. Moved around the seat, that's about it. Nothing else.
But when she was standing, did she try to pull her pants down?
No. No.
Did she do, you said she kind of did like this. Did she ever do anything down here?
No. Because at that time, if she asked me, do you want me to show you? I was like, no, I'm good.
She did ask if?
Yeah.
What'd she say?
I said, no, I'm good.
When was that? Where was everybody then?
I think that was in the car.
Okay, I don't think you said that last time.
I think I did.
Yeah. Maybe you did, and then maybe I just missed it. So she was in the car and said, do you want me to show you?
When she did the shake thing, and she's like, you want me to show you? I was like, no.
Show you what?
Just as, I guess she's trying to mean as far as just a boom or something, if anything's in her bra or anything like that.
But that was after you already had her lift up her shirt
right,
a little bit.
Right, because that was at the front right fender.
Okay. And like I said, I may have missed that or got confused. We've talked about a lot. So she asked you when she's sitting in your car, do you want me to show you?
Right.
And you said no. Did she attempt it?
No. And that was after the...
After she was kind of doing like this?
Yeah.
A thing that kind of concerns me is everything you're telling me is dead on to what she says. Everything. Except the sexual stuff.
Nothing was done as far as that. Nothing.
She smelled anything else besides alcohol?
Just a little bit, like I said, when I was in this car seat. But I asked her if anything else was on board. She just said pills.
Did she smell, though, like weed?
Not PCP or anything with a stink that I would smell.
Right.
I didn't smell any weed inside the car. I didn't smell any weed on her person. That's about it.
Got any questions?
I'm just bombarded with questions.
I know. Do you have any? Do you want to bombard us with any questions?
No, I don't. I don't have any questions.
We might, as far as the, you said you take the lie detector test.
Right.
Do you have any extra job? Is there a time when you can't take a lie detector test?
No.
You can take it at any time?
I can take it at any time.
You're not scheduled for vacation coming up?
I'm not scheduled for vacation.
Okay. Where are you at on your days on right now?
This will be my second day on.
Okay.
Wednesday.
So you're Tuesday to Tuesday?
Tuesday to Tuesday.
You take any testosterone booster?
I do take a pro hormone, which is over the counter, BYN, Beyond Nutrition, which is off Memorial and Penn-ish.
What's that do to your nuts? You know how
they say it shrinks your nuts.
Does it?
They say they shrinks your nuts.
Are your nuts shrunk?
I don't think they are.
I mean, well, you would notice. You know your ball size.
I don't think they have shrunk.
Does it do anything to your penis?
Nope.
You have any problem getting it up?
I don't.
You have any problem ejaculating?
I don't.
What's it called? BYN.
BYN. Beyond Your Nutrition.
Is that the name of the store or what you take?
It's off the store.
What's the stuff you take?
It's called Methadrol.
Does it make you hornier when you're on that?
Supposedly, science says that it's supposed to increase your testosterone levels.
Do you
feel? So, which in case, I guess, makes you more.
Wait, how long have you been taking that?
On and off for maybe a year.
So, do you think you want it more since you've been on that? I mean, if you're doing it once a day, that's a lot.
Plus jacking off.
I think. Plus jacking off.
From my age, I don't think that's a lot.
Was it that before you took this stuff?
Yeah. I think that's probably why I'm a bigger guy, is because I have higher testosterone. I'm an athlete.
And do you think you have a high sex drive?
Yeah.
Do you like oral sex? Normal?
I like it all.
Do you prefer vaginal? Would you rather get a blowjob or do it in the hoo-ha?
Do it. Me? You take it in the
hoo-ha? No. You give it in the hoo-ha or get a blowjob?
Sex.
Sex? What about anal sex?
No, I don't like that.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll just step out.
I had some questions about some midgets, but I guess I'll leave that alone.
Have you ever had sex with a dude?
I've never had sex with a dude.
Do you ever wanted to?
I do not. I did not want to mess with a guy.
Okay, thanks.
We powwow and then we keep right. you.
The gal was talking about that Terry Morris, the one, the other person. Okay, yeah. You're saying the same thing. Okay, you say it was downtown. She was walking. Okay, so mm-hmm. when I say a stop, that's you see her walking, like a voluntary contact.
Right.
Okay. Here, think of a cross between this is one picture and this is her. She look familiar?
No.
No.
Mm-mm.
Now you stopped her for sure. And ran here okay. on a different day. It was May 8th. Okay. You sure she doesn't look familiar at all? Now, when you stopped her, over at the Liberty apartment area,
mm-hmm.
okay, that's where you stopped her on May 8th.
Okay.
Okay. Now, does that ring a bell at all?
No, never.
Okay. All right. Now, you ran her then. Okay. Now, she says that you stopped her later on, like I say, later on in the month. There's more kind of a downtown area. Does that ring a bell at all?
I don't recall any of those pictures. I don't recall any of that. Okay. I don't ever go downtown besides if I go to the gas station or county or...
Off-duty jobs. Where do you work off-duty jobs?
I don't have an off-duty. I'm a courtesy officer at my apartment.
Okay. So besides the Bolero and...
Maybe county. Viper here and there. Maybe.
Okay.
That's within our...
Were you...
On-duty.
But you're running Viper... Out of Spring Lake?
Out of Spring Lake.
Okay. All right. You ever, with your car, you ever go visit anybody, any buddies, anything like that? Or
no.
Shopping, anything?
No.
Okay. Why would, and granted, you're not even recalling her on the May 8th.
Right.
Okay. But that's, I just wanted you to have a frame of mind of who's making this, these statements against you. Okay. And it's the exact same thing, too, stop her, have her sit in the back seat, run for warmth, then you have her get her out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Unzip the pants. I mean, on and on and on. We can go through.
I mean, it's
to a T.
It's exactly the same.
Yeah, I don't recall any of those people. I don't think I recognize those people.
What if you could recall?
This is the same one. This is the same one. I'm just showing you a picture.
How she's changed.
Yeah, this has changed. Okay.
That's the same girl.
It's two different time periods, but she looks kind of in between. It's the same girl.
Okay.
Okay. Still nothing, even vaguely. She's always on the northeast side, mm-hmm. 23rd and Kelly, 36. Kelly.
Uh-huh.
All right. But she described you to a T.
Okay.
Okay. And like I said, it's everything. Everything, You don't remember her, even forget what she's saying. You don't remember her offering a ride to the shelter?
I run in contact with a lot of people, and especially at Liberty Station, that's where I patrol. That's my area. Okay. Well, it's Charlie 3, but my sector. I go there all the time.
Where is that? Just because I don't know.
26 and Lindsay area. So, I don't bring anyone to the shelter. I don't. If I was asked, I would be like, find another way. I don't have
yeah,
brought
you,
anyone to the
Yeah, it's a good
shelter.
Way to get somebody in the car.
Yeah.
Do you remember having contact with a female like that age, okay, that, said she was going from a shelter, from a rehab center, even saying, you'd take her,
I know.
Driving her around, anything like that?
I know.
Okay. Do you ever... Every time you have a female in the back, do you go 10-14 or you just kind of zip on over?
No, I know. All the times if I do, it's supposed to say policy, you're supposed to let
okay.
them dispatch.
Who
no.
cares about policy right now? Because we don't at
right.
this point. Do you do the mileage and do all that or?
Can't, here and there.
Sometimes you don't?
Sometimes I don't.
Okay.
Okay.
I don't know.
Zip on back to this other deal. You're saying about a 15-minute traffic stop. How long do you usually take on traffic stop, just on average?
Maybe 20 minutes.
Now, that's a long
maybe.
Time.
Now,
maybe.
20 minutes, and I'll give it to you. Just even doing the gang stuff and all that,
mm-hmm.
okay. 20 minutes, now that's gonna be some 800 time, right?
800,
okay.
Searching the car in detail, all of that.
Okay, so doing all of that, all the mm-hmm. running, waiting in line, and even on a search. Now, the question I have is, we got a lapse of time here, so I'm kind of get a better handle on where the time went. You're talking about 15 minutes, mm-hmm. no 800, no running on the computer, you shut it down. Mm-hmm. And you said it was just a quick little search of the car. Where's the rest of that time?
Just talking to her.
About what?
Just see where you're going, trying to get her to confess, are you drunk or not? Like, are you been drinking? Because I could smell it when I was in the car, but I can't really get it.
What if she just said, yes, I'm drunk?
I probably would have took her down.
Did you do any tests?
I didn't do any sobriety tests. Just from inside the car, smelling it, and that's about it. Emotional, maybe.
But even that'd be just within a minute or two. I mean, I used to be a DRE, so I know how long those questions will last. So then you switch on over. But nothing?
Nothing.
Okay. So I didn't hear a lot of drunk questions, you know, like... How much
have you been drinking? Mm-hmm. Mainly it's just, have you been drinking? Try to get her confessed. See anything inside that juice? No. Why are you driving so late at 2:00? I don't know. Where are you going? Going to Arbor on the west side. Who are you going to see? Just trying to just talk to her.
Right there, those questions maybe took 40 seconds. 15 minutes?
And you said 5 at the car. So then we got 10 of a lot of questions.
Right.
Okay. I mean, you tell me it wasn't there. I don't have any audio.
And that's what I'm saying. Roughly on a traffic stop, take about 20 minutes. It was the quickest traffic stop, about 15 minutes.
That's your quickest traffic stop?
No.
Okay, you're a slowpoke.
I don't really get 1090 at all or anything like that, but I take my time sometimes.
But you didn't write her tickets.
Didn't write her ticket.
You didn't write her.
Didn't run her.
You didn't even put yourself out.
Didn't put myself out.
How could you take 15 minutes on that?
Just talking. I must have been talking. So. That's it.
I can't see her wanting to talk if she's crying and asking if you're going to shoot her and all this. I don't see her being real forthcoming with conversation.
Whether my questions or whatnot. That's it.
You don't seem... I don't know how you were out there, but just kind of talking with you. I mean, you seem real laid back and everything like that. I've never got the impression of just kind of an angry type cop. We know some.
Right.
You know, that, you might would ask. But I don't see that question coming up of you.
Right.
And you're not saying she was drunk or high or...
I didn't think she was drunk over legal limit, .08. And like I said, I didn't make any threats to her. She was just emotional because maybe the gun deal or she saw a cop and
what
she was
gun
just,
deal?
She said, you got a gun. So I was like, calm down.
Duh, everybody's.
Yeah, and so I guess she brought that up and I was like, calm down.
When she asked about the, you got a gun, what point did she ask that?
She asked that right when we were searching the passage and when we were in the back of the car.
So she brought
twice?
It up twice?
Twice.
She just says, you got a gun, or what?
Yeah, and then starts crying, and I'm like, don't get emotional, it's okay.
Did she ever say, you shouldn't do this?
No.
Or I can't do this?
No.
She just says, you got a gun.
You got a gun.
Are you gonna shoot me?
No, I don't think she's ever said that.
No, you said last time. Did she?
Maybe she said that, but then I was like, "Do you have any bad runs in with the cops?" And she's like, "No."
That just doesn't fit. That's just weird.
And that's what I mean. I'm kind of in there too. I don't know if I didn't think she was drunk, but I know there's pills on board. I don't know. So.
Do you carry a Glock? Don't have it on. I don't even pay attention. You said the one you got in the academy?
Yes.
What else you taking besides that pro-hormone?
It's about creatine.
What in the creatine?
Just creatine. Monohydrate. I don't know exact ingredients in it.
But I'm saying, is it in something? I mean, is it like an intro workout, a pre-workout?
Yeah, pre-workouts are in creatine.
Okay. But give me the names of what you're using.
There's a lot of supplements I take.
How much money you spend on supplements? It
costs a lot. Supplements cost a lot.
Start rattling them.
C4 pre-workout. No explode. Let's see. Dimetize has some. A condense.
Dimetize has what? You mean for your protein?
I take their protein.
You taking any injection?
No, no. It's pro hormones.
Okay. You got anything to offset the pro hormone stuff?
Liver pills. Because I guess it's bad to take oral. So I take liver pills. And that's about it. Multivitamins. Med sports, multivitamins. And that's about it.
All this stuff, does it make you, you ever get mad?
I don't. Then
aggressive?
That all is a myth.
Is it?
It's a myth. That's just based on the guy's personality, I guess. And whatnot.
Have you ever roided?
Have I did steroids? No. I've been around it in college. NFL, I've seen guys do it. College, I've seen guys do it.
You didn't do it?
Never did it.
How come?
I started as a true freshman in college, so I got random tested by NCAA. NCAA tests for all that. As far as steroid use, and you get tested in college just for street drugs. So I didn't know when randomly they could do it.
I didn't want to put the other guys worried about it. What happened if they got caught on it?
I don't think they didn't care. I cared. I didn't want to. I started as a true freshman. I didn't want to do that. Wasn't about me. I was a big bone kid. I didn't need to get stronger. I didn't feel like I think that would come natural. I didn't feel like I needed to get faster or anything like that.
What happened if you got caught doing it in a random test?
The NCAA would suspend you. You'd be dead.
But like anything, there's always something before they ban it and stuff.
Yeah.
The old Andro days and stuff.
Yeah. So.
Did you do the supplements and all that then?
Yeah, but you had to be a little careful as far as talk to your team doctor, what's in this, is this FDA approved? Just don't have that risk of actually, getting tested for a small ingredient and whatnot.
So you don't think 15 minutes was too long on that traffic stop?
No,
and nothing sexual went on during that 15 minutes?
Nothing sexual.
When you said you were going to follow her, but she took too long, how long is too long?
Where you turn off the lights, okay, go ahead. Wait just a little bit, wait a little bit. Okay, so I hooked a U-turn and went.
30 seconds, 45 seconds, a minute?
Maybe a little bit longer than a minute.
What was she doing? Could you see in the window?
I just saw her just pull up a little bit, kind of stalled and slow creep up, and I'm like, what are you doing? And go, and I'll follow you. But then I just, boom, hit the U-turn, went north on north, 235, Rockway Extension.
Okay. We're going to call tomorrow. We can't get a hold of the polygrapher today.
Okay.
And get that scheduled.
Okay.
And I'll call you on your cell phone.
Okay.
And tell you when it is.
Okay.
Do you know where it's at the training center? Did you?
When we did the academy, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'll call you and we gotta get that all set up. And
okay.
I'll call you. Get your schedule. Powwow one more time. Any questions?
No, I don't have any questions.
Can Daniel come? Maybe he can be like, hey, ask
a little toasty in here.
It is a little toasty. We can keep this open. Your pants. These are the pants you wore last shift.
Yes.
It is?
Yes.
Okay. What about your underwear?
No.
Where are they at?
In the wash.
They're in the washer?
Washer.
Washer.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, you need your pants.
Okay.
I didn't figure you'd have a problem. Okay, we're trying to figure out a way to speed this on along. I don't know what it's been. What would you? We're trying to figure out whether just to figure out.
It's you guys, on. Whatever you guys want to do. You guys call.
I don't know.
It's your guys' call.
I know.
If you don't want me, I'll drop one.
Yeah. Okay. You don't want to wear like some Tyvek pants or something home? Does that matter?
I don't care. Whatever.
Okay.
Whatever.
Who all was home when you got home?
My girlfriend, Carrie Hunt.
You live with anybody else?
No, no.
Is she a policeman?
No, she's not.
Carrie Hunt. What's her number?
Can you go through my phone?
Yeah.
As much as I don't want to get her involved.
We're not going to tell her what's going on. But we are going
to. Tell her whatever you want to.
Yeah, we're not going
to. Her number is going to be 918.
Does she work? Are we gonna, if we call?
She does work.
She
works
work
normal 8 to 5 hours, Monday through Friday.
Okay. Where does she work?
At a Crest and Oil Memorial in MacArthur area. Around there.
Okay. Yeah, we're getting those tie-backs to go.
Don't call her.
Okay.
You created some more work. Fixing to go. I just talked to Karen.
Okay.
She said she was asleep when you got home, and you did not try to have sex, and you did not have sex. She said you didn't. And I asked her, could you have been asleep, and you kind of, no, and she said no. You did not try to have sex.
As much as I don't want to bother her, I tried to have sex with her, and she was asleep. Karen goes to sleep pretty early, about 9, 10 at the late.
Okay, but she would know if you tried. I'm a woman.
I know.
And my husband comes home in the middle of the night, and I'm like, are you kidding me? I've been asleep. You said you twirled around her vagina.
I did.
And you put it in a little bit, and then she said, I'm tired. No.
I did.
She would remember that to tell me.
She
said you did not try to have sex.
And it's more personal because it's Carrie, but I did try to have sex with Carrie. I did.
I don't know what to say. I mean, because it just looks like I just caught you in a lie. And now I don't know what to believe.
I'm telling you.
I don't know what to believe.
Okay.
Because you tell me this, I go to verify it. She tells me the opposite, and now I'm wondering what you're telling the truth about.
Maybe because she doesn't know what the heck's going on.
No, she doesn't. I didn't tell her.
And I'm glad, but detectives calling her, any other officer asking her a question like that.
I know.
She's maybe scared. And I don't want to involve her, but
she's involved.
That's
because
my
you,
girlfriend. That's like
you need her involved for you,
right?
But now she's given the story that you're not given.
I'm telling you, I tried to have sex with Carrie, my girlfriend.
She is gonna remember your weenie twirling around her hoo-ha. You remember that? I don't care how much of a sleeper you are. You remember because it pisses you off in the middle of the night, and you go, "Are you serious? Don't bother me with that."
Maybe you should call and ask her if she's a deep sleeper. Because there's multiple times I've tried to do that. Multiple times we've had sex. Multiple times she has pushed
me
off.
Well, you told me that you have sex every day, and she says you did not have sex today.
We didn't have sex today. No. We didn't.
Well, you said you have sex every day.
Mostly every day, yes.
So if I call her back, is she going to tell me that you'll have sex every day?
We did not have sex, but recently, mostly all every day, yeah.
I'm a woman, and I know what it feels like to be woke up for sex, and I don't like that, and you remember it, and I don't believe you.
I'm telling you the truth. I'm sorry. I tried to have sex with my girlfriend. I did.
I don't know. You're a dude. Does your wife get pissed off if you try to wake her up in the middle of the
night?
She
had white thong on and a t-shirt. And
okay, you talk to him. I'm going to go call her again.
Okay.
Because right now, I don't believe it.
Hey, the pants.
You want me to bring them in?
Yeah.
In a plastic bag?
Yeah.
I mean, a brown paper sack. Okay, don't start yet.
I don't know.
And that's probably her message or whatever. I don't.
She's like, what?
And I wish
we well, we're not
gonna involve her, Carrie.
Well, we're not gonna tell her. You're gonna have to explain whatever the situation is.
That's what happened.
You got any questions of all this?
I'm getting attacked now. I'm just feeling. I'm like, God bless. I want DNA, I want everything, I want to get it done.
We're going to put it to the front of the line, okay?
Get it done.
I can tell you, it usually takes a long time, but because of the situation, we will put it at the front of the line, okay?
Yeah.
I mean, usually on this stuff, we do whatever we can.
Here is shorts and a shirt. I don't know if the shirt will fit in the set. Before I call Carrie.
Yes.
You
shirt.
Tried to have sex with Carrie.
I tried
not
to have my
else.
Girlfriend, yes. That was in my bed, yes.
Do you ever cheat on her?
No.
So it's only Carrie right now?
Carrie.
Okay.
All right, man. Pants in this bag and just put the. Unless you want to keep the shirt on. I don't know. I don't know if this shirt's going to be big enough for you here. There you go, boy. was going to get a Tyvek, so I don't know where these came from. Well, can you think of anything?
Will it be okay if I tell my family about this? And
no, you tell them.
Okay.
It's your life, man. Look, we usually have to spend as much time anytime there's an allegation, okay, trying to clear up the matter, right, one way or the other.
I just don't want my girlfriend involved, you know, or something. I try to have sex with my girlfriend. As bad as that sounds, and as bad as that sounds when she's asleep, yeah.
No, you're fine. Hey, I try to crawl up my wife all the time. Hey, she shoots me down.
I think she's probably, just imagine her just being all nervous and whatnot, you know, just.
Well, you can get home and kind of explain everything.
So what goes on from now? There she is.
Jesus. Well, you're headed home, obviously, because you need some pants. Why don't you go ahead and get dressed then?
Why we stay here?
Yeah, stay there. Okay. We're really done with you.
Okay.
Just hang back.
Can I message her and say I'll, because she's probably blowing on my phone. I'll talk to you.
You're fine.
Hey, baby. Babe.
Yeah.
I need to tell you what's going on. It's crazy. I'm basically on my way home, and I'd like to talk to you. What's going on? It's crazy. Yeah, they're gonna give me a ride, so I don't know, probably 10, 15 minutes. Till I get 15, yeah, around there. I don't know, 15, 20, 30 minutes around there. Yes. I don't know. I gotta tell you, it's crazy. It's nuts. I gotta
So, I love you, okay?
Okay.
I love you.
Hey Dan.
Hey man.
Oh, it's hot in here.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, until this investigation gets all completed, what's going on, we're going to put you on administrative leave with pay, okay?
Sure.
Just part of procedures, you know, and they got to do this until it gets all taken care of,
yeah.
Okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you this to sign that you're receiving it, and I'm going to give you a copy to take home. I want you to read it very carefully when you get home, because there's some detailed stuff that people forget to read. You know, such as you got to check in with me on every Tuesday morning before 9 o'clock.
Okay.
Call me at the station and just make sure I know who you are and where you're at.
Mm-hmm.
There's some things we got to take from you. I think there's firearms already in there.
Yes, sir.
In the deal. Do you have your shirt in here? We'll get your badge off that.
Yeah.
Is that the only badge you have?
Yes, because the other badge is upstairs because it was... got lost during the foot chase. So,
okay.
Yeah, the one's upstairs.
Upstairs where?
With Susan, chief
okay,
assistant.
So you haven't got a replacement yet?
I haven't yet.
You have not? Okay.
Okay.
Well, we need to find out about that as well. So you just have the one on the deck and whatever. Let's go ahead and get that from you.
Okay.
And we're going to need your radio too. We'll just kind of check it off as we go here.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, sir. So we got the badge and that radio there. Lieutenant Gregory's going to take you home, too, get you right home.
Are you still up on North Main?
Yes, sir.
14200?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, we've got the badge. And then do you have your commission card and entry card with you?
I do.
Okay.
And this, the seal missing is from the last foot chase thing,
yes,
right?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay.
So we have the entry card and we have the...
Plea card, entry card.
Okay. Is that your entry card?
Is this, I'm sorry.
What do you have here? Okay, is that all?
Plea card is commission card.
Okay, we'll take all that.
Is entry card.
We got all that. And here, do you have anything else besides your firearm? Do you have a shotgun?
I do have a shotgun.
Is it in your vehicle?
It's at home.
It's at home, okay.
Yeah.
I'll get that.
He'll grab that when he goes with you and grab that. He'll probably grab your radio charger as well.
Okay.
And any spare batteries you have there. You don't have a taser.
I don't have a taser.
Nothing like that.
No, no.
I have your keys to your car. Do you have any keys to the station or anything like that?
No, no.
Okay. All right. And that's going to be it. Okay. I'm going to let you sign this that you're receiving it, okay? And I'm going to give you your own copy, okay? So you can read it. Now, you can't wear your uniform. Of course, we have all your badge and gun. You can't work extra jobs. Can't drive city vehicles. And then, you know, those guys will be in touch with you for any further follow-up with that.
Okay.
You know, and if you be sure to read this, like I said, because, you know, if you go out of town, you got to call and let us know first.
Okay.
If you go, if you're going to go out of state, you need to get permission from us.
Okay.
Read it very carefully.
Okay.
That's your copy right there. And I'm going to witness it. Okay. I think that's it. Arthur?
Okay.
And you'll take I'll take that in the badge if you want to.
Okay.
I'll just take that. If you can get the...
And I'll get the things that he has at home.
Yeah. And I'm...
Let me call you back.
I'm pretty sure that Melvin's working tonight.
Okay.
And he can just let you in my office and stick it in there.
Okay.
I'm almost positive he is working tonight, I would guess.
And he's going to take these things home?
Yes, he can take those home. You can take those home. Those items with you, you can take.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
Okay, thanks, Arthur. I will probably bring those things back.
Okay. Now, I'll grab the thing.
Okay.
Arthur, I do need the magazine.
Okay.
I need it down there. I need it
down. Okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and grab.
All right, thank you.
Sorry about that. Okay, you ready?
Yes.